The Colombo High Court sentenced former Army Commander Sarath Fonseka to 3 years in jail on Friday after finding him guilty of making a false allegation against the President's brother and Defence Secretary Gotabaya Rajapaksa. Fonseka, a key architect of the military strategy that saw the defeat of the separatist Tamil Tigers, ran against President Mahinda Rajapaksa in 2010 elections. Large crowds flocked to the High Court premises in support of Fonseka. Fonseka is already serving a 30-month prison term after a court-martial convicted him of irregularities in military procurements. Three-judge bench in a 2-1 judgment found Fonseka guilty of violating emergency regulations by spreading rumors and causing public disorder in an interview with a weekly newspaper. He had alleged that Defense Secretary Gotabaya Rajapaksa had ordered the execution of surrendering Tamil Tiger cadres in the final stages of the separatist conflict in May 2009. One of the judges cleared Fonseka of all three charges brought against him, court officials said. Fonseka has the right to appeal, AFP reported. Lighting for the 8 interchanges and bridges along Sri Lanka's first expressway, which has run into trouble over inadequate space on its service lane, has already cost 6 million rupees per month, RDA chairman revealed.
We have already established lighting facilities at the interchanges, 8 interchanges, as well as on bridges. And this will operate throughout the night, and the cost of the lighting would be very high, and we will have to bear the cost for the lighting charges. Like the side of the road, there is barriers. There's a barriers. On these barriers, we have installed reflectors. That will reflect the light of the vehicle, and that will show the path of the expressway. And as you said, throughout this road there will not be lighting, and that will be at a huge cost. And even in the other countries also, I have not seen throughout the length they have provided the lighting.
The 95-kilometer expressway is to be opened on November 27th by President Mahinda Rajapaksa. Meanwhile, an organization of transport professionals has warned that Sri Lanka's first expressway has serious flaws that could make 100 kilometers an hour travel unsafe. The Chartered Institute of Logistics and Transport, while commending the Road Development Authority for completing the island's first expressway, has warned that changes in design and bad driving habits could create safety hazards. The organization has questioned whether safety features were compromised in cost-cutting. The CILT Sri Lanka called for a road safety culture and recommended training of drivers before they get on the expressway and restricting maximum speed to 80 km per hour initially. The reduction in lane width owing to cost overruns does not allow for safe overtaking at higher speeds and space for emergency stopping of vehicles on the roadside or the service lane, the statement said. President Mahinda Rajapaksa, on turning 66 years today, has wished prosperity and peace of mind to all Sri Lankans. Percy Mahinda Rajapaksa, who was born on November 18, 1945, is the 6th President and Commander-in-Chief of the Sri Lankan Armed Forces. A lawyer by profession, Rajapaksa was first elected to the Parliament in 1970 and served as Prime Minister from 2004 until his victory at the 2005 presidential election. He was sworn in for a 6-year term as president in 2005. He was re-elected for a second term in office on January 27, 2010. Rajapaksa was educated at Richmond College, Galle, before moving to Nalanda College and later Thurston College, Colombo. Under President Mahinda Rajapaksa's political leadership, the three-decade-long conflict with the separatist Tamil Tigers was ended by the military. Yaldevi will resume its journey from Colombo Fort to Jaffna by 2013, Indian High Commissioner Ashok K. Kanta said.
We hope that by end of 2013, Yaldevi Express will once again be running to Kakisanthurai, as Honorable Minister just mentioned. And likewise, full connectivity will be restored once again up to Talaimannar. I believe this will be a development of momentous significance in Sri Lanka.
The Indian High Commissioner was speaking at a ceremony held to sign an agreement for the reconstruction of the railway line between Pale and Kankasanthurai between Sri Lanka's Railways and Ercon International Limited, India. At the ceremony, Transport Minister Kumara Velgama expressed views on the private bus strike called off this week.
මම හැම වෙලාවකම කියන්නේ බස් වර්ජන වලට මූණ දෙන්න මම කැමතියි කියලා. මොකද මම යකඩත් එක්ක හැප්පිච්ච මිනිහෙක්. මම පොඩි කුඩා කාලේ ඉඳන් ප්‍රවාහනයත් එක්ක ගැටිච්ච කෙනෙක්. ඒ නිසා මේක අපිට එච්චර කාර්යයක් නෙවෙයි. මොකද ලංගමේ බස් රථ දැන් අපි වැඩි කරගෙන යනවා. එදා අපි මංග බාර ගන්නකොට ලංගමේ බස් රථ 4300 ඒකත් කැඩි කැඩි ගියේ. දැන් අද 5500 දක්වා වැඩි කරලා තියෙනවා. තව ටික දවසක් යනකොට මම 7500 දක්වා වැඩි කරනවා. එතකොට මට පුද්ගලික අංශය මං හිතන්නේ ගැමුණු විජේරත්න මහත්මයලා හැම මොනවා කිව්වත් ඒකට මූණ දෙන්න කුමාර වෙල්ගමට ශක්තියක් තියෙනවා කියන එක මම මේ අවස්ථාවේ ප්‍රකාශ කරන්න ඕන.
Internationally renowned terrorism expert Rohan Gunaratna says Sri Lanka should punish individuals responsible for human rights abuses if credible evidence is forwarded.
Prabhakaran deliberately engineered a humanitarian crisis. And I think that Sri Lanka needs to build a robust capability to defend some of the misinformation and disinformation. But certainly, if there are credible instances of human rights violations, Sri Lankan government should punish those individuals who have committed those atrocities. That is very important. As Sri Lanka moves on, it must set very high standards. But with regard to these allegations that deliberately the Sri Lankan forces targeted the Tamils, I want to say that never happened, because I myself spent an extraordinary amount of time in the north and the east, and I don't think that any Sri Lankan soldier will want to kill a Tamil because someone is a Tamil, you see. I think that if Sri Lankan forces deliberately kill Tamils in the no-fire zone, I don't think 280,000 Tamils will come to the Sri Lankan security forces and seek their assistance.
Gunaratna was addressing the British Scholars Association on the future of Sri Lankan security, countering the LTT on Western soil.
As in every war in Iraq, Afghanistan, there are such isolated atrocities. The government has taken action against some of those atrocities, and I believe that if there is sufficient evidence, government will take action against other cases as well.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter and Facebook.